Hello, welcome to this lesson of our study of abstract algebra. So in this lesson we'll just go through order of a group and order of the elements of a group. Okay, all right, so if you have not subscribed to the channel, kindly subscribe to support the channel as well. Okay, all right, let's start. So order of a group. Now, when you say the order of a group, it is the number of elements in the set G, okay, of a group. So the set that you'll be given, the number of elements in that particular set is what we call the order of the group. Okay. I hope this is okay. All right. So this is denoted as this. Okay. Just two bars, and you put the G inside. You write equals that. Okay, so if I write something like this equals 2, it means in that particular group that we are talking about, number of elements in the set. Okay, I hope you remember the set is G is always a set under a certain operation. Okay, so let's say the set consists of 1 and 2 and it has its own operation, then these two elements will constitute the number of elements there. Okay, so we have only 2 elements, or it can be 1 and 4. You have only 2 elements, so it means the order of this is what? 2. I hope you get this. All right, let's pick some examples and work with that. Okay, given that G is equal to Z says under addition. Okay, Z says, this Z says means when you see something like this in group theorem or in group study, it means you are dealing with modulosis. Okay, this modulus, in the modulosis the operation here is what? Addition. Okay, so to solve this we have to write modulosis. What is the set? The set starts from 0 1 2 3, okay, 4 and 5. Okay, it ends at 5. I hope you remember this. So with this, the answer is very simple. How many elements do we have here? 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, indeed, or in fact, for modulo, integer modulo, the nth modulo is the number of elements in a group, or the nth modulo is simply the order of the group. Here what I mean is that we are dealing with modulo 6, the order of the group will be 6. Okay, so it means the order of this group, which is G, is equal to 6. You are done. Like that, very simple, like that. Okay, all right, let's move on to the next one. The next one is saying find this means what? The order of G, for G equals Z3, like that. And since this is Z3 and it's still modulo, it means the order of this G is what? 3. You can indeed list Z3 and the set will give you 0 1 2. Okay, and you have 3 elements. So, and you can go through them and see if this is a group. We said if it is a group, there are some axioms it should obey. First of all, the axiom, the first one is it should be close. Second, it should be what? Associative. Third, there should be an identity element. The fourth one is there should be an inverse for each of the elements. And indeed, when you do the modulo, we'll actually perform a modulo table, don't worry. Okay, so that you'll be able to remember if you have already forgotten, but stay tuned. Okay, now let's move on to the next subtopic, which is a group that has infinite number. Okay, so a group that has infinite number of elements is said to have infinite order. Okay, this is very important, infinite order. So when you see that the number of elements in the set that constitute a group is infinite, then it means the order of the group is infinite. Now let's look at the integer under addition, the operation in addition. So the whole of the integers, we don't know them, is infinite. So if I know the integers, this Z is being listed as this, the like that. Okay, then -1 0 1. Okay, this means that from negative infinity are coming up to positive infinity, and you don't know the elements inside. So all that we can say is that this is infinite. There's infinite elements here, so it has infinite order. Okay, and the same thing with the real numbers under the operation of addition. Okay, that is also one of the examples of infinite how do you call it, group. Okay, so infinite order group. Okay, a group that has infinite order. You can search for other examples online and see them, okay? All right, let's look at order of element of a group. So within the group, okay, let's pick this group for example. Within this group, okay, these elements here, what is the order of zero? Okay, so we can find the order of the individual elements. So let's try to also know the definition, okay? Let the elements A belong to G, okay, indeed A is in G, where G is a group, okay? The order of A is the smallest positive integer, which is also positive. Is it that the smallest possible integer, okay? The smallest possible integer, which is also positive. It shouldn't be a negative integer. Such that A to the power K equals E, where E is the identity element. What this means is that how many times do I have to operate A on itself to get my element, identity element E, okay? I will solve an example on that, so don't worry. I said, how many times do you have to operate the element A on itself to get the identity element E? Okay, so let's go ahead and check that. Now, to there's an example here. Find the order of the elements 1, 2, and 4 in the group Z says in addition, how do you call it, operation, okay? So with Z says in addition operation, I hope you know how to do the modulo. If you have forgotten, don't worry. Like I said earlier, I'll do it here. Let me use this, okay? All right, so now with this, let me draw my line here. Well, let's see. How many? 6 elements, right? So I have one of them here. I have another one here. I have the other one here. I think we have everything, okay? So if this should be our plus, okay, let me change the background, okay? Sorry. Okay, that is cool. All right, so I hope this is cool, right? So I have this my plus, okay? This is my plus, okay? And this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 with integer moduluses. So I have 0. Should I go ahead and bring the background so that we write it in order? Okay. So I have 0 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. I hope this will be okay. Sorry. Okay, so with 0 plus 0, you know is 0. So with the integer modulo, the first row where we start with 0 will always maintain the same elements, and the first column is the same thing as well. With the integer modulo with addition, okay. Now 1 plus 1 will give me 2, this will give me 3, this will give me 4, this will give me 5, this will give me 0, okay. I hope you can see this. Now 2 plus, that will give me 3, 2 plus 2 give me 4, 5, 0, 2 plus 5 is 7, in modulo 6 is 1, okay. Then I have 3 plus this 4, 3 plus 2, 5, 3 plus 3, 6, in modulo 6 is 0, 3 plus 4, 7, in modulo 6 is 1. I mean, just subtract 6 multiples of 6 from it, okay? When you have 7, you have only one multiple of 6. You subtract it from 7, you get 1. That is it. 3 plus 5, you get what? 8, right? In modulo 6 is 2. Then I have 5, 4 plus 2 6 0 4 plus 3 7 that and 2 3 5 plus 1 that is 6 0 5 plus 2 that 5 plus 3 you have 2 obviously you know that this is 3 and this is also 4 now this is what we have okay for the table I just wanted to show you how to get the table that is all okay actually we could have done we'll be able to do this without a table okay all right so that is it so we have this now I just wanted to take this opportunity to show you group table how it looks like you can see that from this group okay throughout the whole of this each and every element from the sets appears once and only once in all the rows check you can check from here to here all the elements appears once 3 has appeared only once here and it can never appear in the same row again the same thing happens to the column so if you get a group table and then this thing is violated that in one group or in one column some elements are repeated then it means it's not a group okay so that's another way of checking if a set given under a certain operation is not a group okay so you can perform the group table and then see if some of them appears more than once in a row or in a column then it means that the set given is not a group under that operation okay now the main task here is to find the order of 1, 2, and 4 okay I just wanted to show you the multiplication the group table okay now 1 for 1 okay so let's start for 1 for 1 the question is what is the operation you are dealing with is plus okay under modulo what z6 this is what you should remember the operation is addition and the modulo is a 6 so you pick 1 okay you operate 1 on itself 1 plus 1 okay let me just write it 1 like that and that will give me what 2 2 modulo 6 is still 2 okay so you maintain it like that then you pick 2 okay that answer the final answer you had you pick this final answer this one okay then you add another 1 to it because you are operating 1 on the results again and you have 2 plus 1 you get what 3 then you pick 3 plus 1 so you get the identity elements okay I hope you can see what I'm trying to do here 4 plus 1 that is equal to 5 and 5 plus 1 is equal to 6 in modulo 6 is 0 all of these you will get them just after applying the modulo and then when you apply 2 in modulo 6 you get 2 3 in modulo 6 you get 3 that's why I didn't talk about it okay so you count yourself now I've been able to you know get the how do you call it, the identity element which is 0 because when you go to the group table you could see that 0 is the identity element here because when you add every element to 0 okay and I pick this 0 operate it on 0 I'll get this 0 back I pick 1 operate it on 0 I'll get the 1 back okay so you can see that that is the identity element okay so it's the only element that when you operate all the elements on the on it you get those elements back okay you can see that 3 operated on 0 is still 3 4 operated on 0 is still 4 5 operated on 0 is still 5 it means that 0 is the identity element the other way also is 0 operated on 1 is 1 0 operated on 2 is 2 0 operated on 3 is 3 and 0 operated on 4 is also 4 likewise 5 okay so it means that 0 is identity element so you can also check for their inverses that what element should I operate on 1 okay to get 0 is 5 okay I hope you can see it's 5 so it means the inverse of 1 is 5 this likewise the inverse of 5 is also 1 when you go to 2 2 plus 4 is 0 in modulo 6 it means that 4 plus 2 is also 0 so you can see that they have inverses as well okay so now since we've been able to get our identity elements which is a 0 I should have already told you that the identity element is 0 okay it means that we are supposed to count the number of times 1 appears in this whole operation so 1 just let's count the number of ones inside the code we are dealing with 1 We have one of them here. There's 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 times, okay? So it means that when I pick 1 to the power 6, I'll get 0. In this, it's not just 1 to the power 6 as you see in exponentiation. This is number of times you have to operate 1 on itself to get 0. Okay, so it means that the order of 1 here in this group is actually equal to 6. Very simple like that, okay? So we go to 2. So now we know that we can do 2, okay? So first 2 plus 2, you operate it on itself and you get 4. Then you write this 4 in modulo 6. You are dealing with addition and in Z6, okay? In modulo 6 is still 4. So I pick the 4 again, add another 2 to it, and I'll get 0. So how many times did 2 appear? 1, 2, 3. So it means that 2 to the power 6 is actually equal to 0. Here in group, please, I'm begging you, it's not exponentiation as you see. Or you can see that simply, if you don't want to find yourself in any trouble, don't write this like I'm writing. Just write the order of 2 is equal to 3. Sorry, I said 2 to the power 6. It's 2 to the power 3 rather. I'm really sorry, okay? So it means that the order of 2 is what? 3, because it appears 3 times in its operation. Now let's move on to the next one for 4. For 4, what is the order of 4? I have 4 plus 4, that will give me 8, and in 8 modulo 6 is what? 2, because you are dealing with addition and in Z6. So 8 modulo 6 is 2. Now I pick this 2, I add another 4 to it, and I'll guess what? 0. Because 2 plus 4 is 6, in modulo 6 is 0. So this means that I have 1, 2, 3. 3 of the 4, so it means 4 to the power 3 is equal to 0 in group. Okay? Or like I said, you don't need to write these. All that you need to write is the order of 4 is actually equal to 3. This is very simple like that, okay?